Just an echo, in the valley, but it brings back sweet memories of you. Way back in the year of 1904, was born a baby boy that would later on give the world much pleasure and much joy. Through his school days, he studied law and wasn't sure what he wanted then. But soon he did discover that law was not for him. If you ever go across the seas to Ireland, be it only at the closing of your day, for to see again the moon rise over Cladda and watch the sun go down on Galway Bay. He had a sweet voice and quickly realized what he wanted was to sing, and the world had come to love the man everybody knew as Bing. Now Bing, he was a crooner with a sweet voice soft and low, and very soon he got to singing on the radio. There's a gold mine in the sky far away. We will find it, you and I, some sweet day. And we'll say hello to friends who say goodbye. When we find that long lost gold mine in the sky. He sold records by the million, and his voice had brought much joy to a world so full of sadness, loneliness, and woe. As an actor, he brought pleasure to so many, true to say, in over 50 films, and especially in Going My Way. An Irish lullaby. Always pleasant and good-humoured, and a witty word to say, even though he had his share of sorrow along the way. What would Christmas be without him? Just to hear him once again sing that song of his, White Christmas, to praise the newborn king.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Well, Bing's no longer with us now. He has sadly passed away after finishing a round of golf, the game he loved to play. Now the world had mourned your passing, Bing. There was no time for goodbyes, for the good Lord came and took you home across those clear blue skies.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
must tell you, he's not the hope he used to be. He's getting a little old, a little beat. He's getting a little slouchy in the pouch, so we say. We just finished a picture called The Road to Utopia, and I don't want to say what part of him was dragging, but it's the cleanest road picture we ever made.